Okay, so I'll just close everything. And then probably there's more room to head towards to the top. But they'll do peak, so it keeps going. So there goes once again in terms of scaling. So it keeps scaling on the level of demand. And this one actually, there was a gap, and then all of a sudden it took, but it's okay. In terms of the result, there were a couple just waiting for how many minutes? 4:23:33 from 4:12 to 4:30. 15 minutes, okay, 15 minutes work, just basically waiting and just being confident, being patient in order for that to happen. Okay, so that's basically my end. Any questions from your side of things to my side of things?
Yeah, right. I get you knew to buy just because it was in level of demand?
Correct. So looking at on a daily, simply the daily has just been battered way too much and it created a new lower low on that end. I was worried wouldn't be a right word for it. It's more cautious because the close, the low was 55.93. 55.905, so it actually created a lower low,
yeah.
And that wasn't a good sign for me to create that, to create a new lower low from there. So it could easily potentially have gone to the opposite side, to be honest, in my own opinion. And then, so likewise, even for 1 hour, of course, that was going through on a bearish candle right there. You can't really see it. I mean, you see it, but on the 30 minutes. 30 minutes they were playing the game, especially on the 15 minutes as well. There's a confirmation. One was on the 5 minute time frame. There's no confirmation here. I actually got in way too early because of this confirmed here over there. And then the doji happened at the very end. Then when I have the confirmation. So I put my stop, was calculating how much I was willing to risk, and they weren't pushing the price for some reason within the low. See that there's here, all the lows on this end, they don't want to go through within that low. So at one point, there was an extol, it was awesome to watch, like nothing was moving. It's almost like, it just gives me a flashback when we were in Chicago, no one was placing the bid or the ask, market maker just created the price, and then out of nowhere, smack, there's a little bit more of increase in volume, so that one, didn't want to buy anymore, to be honest, because I'm getting too much, and then this, yeah, this low was hovering here, 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 and then bam, that's where the report basically came in. So, once you're level of demand and you're seeing the lows, they don't want to go through in that low, it's pretty much you have a low risk, high probability. Of course, my stop was about 55.81, just didn't want to go even deeper than that. And then that's when the report. So, actually, just excuse me for 1 second, I just have to close another position, okay? Around the corner, just 1 sec. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, yes, I hope I answered your question right there, James.
Yeah, and it could have gone against you, but the probability is high enough, and you play the game long enough with those kinds of analyses, and you come out ahead, you find. It's good.
Yeah. plus the feeling aspect, the intuition aspect is also an element without panicking. So of course also calculating first on how much I really was willing to risk. So this particular point in time, it's a 1-to-1 reward to risk ratio. If I calculate in terms of 800, they're actually only willing to risk $500 part of the trade. Okay, but I ended up more than that, like $800, right? Okay, Harry, I believe you have a question.
You executed on the 1 minute. Do you normally want to grade the views on 1 minute chart, or is that fine?
Since the change of the commission structure in terms of the price, I've been loving the 1 minute. The reason is because, like, if you see, like, the pound dollar, like, at one point it was, like, actually negative zero. It's like, you can't really, like, see, if you're seeing this, you know, you're almost in the same price point, like, all in the same price points, and the price keeps going up. So, yeah. It's 1 minute. I can see a clearer picture of the 1 minute. I'm also looking in terms of the tick chart, looking at the lows, see in terms of the price to make it also cleaner. Same price based on that. I just can see a much clearer picture. As long as I know what to look for on the bigger time frame, then I will also know what to do on the smaller time frame. Okay. Any other questions? Okay, nothing. Alrighty. I'll go through one by one and let's see what you guys have done from top to bottom. I'll go through from you first, Samantha.
Okay, so initially I was just kind of waiting for news to happen, and I came in around this point, but since I saw a higher low, I was a little skeptical and I didn't get in right away. I kind of hesitated, but I finally got in at here and I saw the lower high going short, but I was really wary about this, like, stalling. So when the news hit, I was a little too slow, but I got in at about here, but instead I just, like, loaded up on it to make up for what I lost, and I practiced trailing myself.
All right, so very nice. So what difference compared to last week and the week before?
Even though I wasn't sure what was going to happen, I took advantage of the situation and I just really focused. Like, I'm honestly kind of shaking right now because I was, like, so in the zone.
Yeah.
And I really like trailing stops. I didn't really do that before on the minute chart, but it was really great. So.
Okay, cool.
And also I liked putting more on it when it went along. That makes a difference too.
So what was your intention for the trade for today? Like, in terms of the live trading, what intention did you create for yourself?
My intention was to learn how to trail my stops, like, manually, and then also to put more on it. And I totally forgot to do that at this point, but then when the news hit, I started adding to my positions and stuff. So.
Okay, very nice. Very good. Excellent. All right, next, let's go through with Rugo.
I enter here on this bullish candle. And then get out of the trade here, and then this trade went wrong, and then I get up here, and one on, one off, and then on this bearish candle, I accidentally pressed the short, but then I was supposed to do the long one, but accidentally do it, so I closed it.
Mm-hmm.
And then here's the news time, and then done for you.
Okay, great. So you've been very busy, very nice. Okay. Just buying very quick through there. Buy, sell, okay? No worries. So what was your intention? What were you creating for yourself in terms of practice today?
Just to follow the candles, like how the candle is behaving, reacting, mm-hmm. like the force of the candle, because I don't have much time to think about the lower lows and higher lows, so I forgot that and just follow the candle.
Okay. And now based on the force of the candles, notice that there are no force, hence, technically speaking, what you should have been doing.
Like, I should not do these things here.
Yeah, so in other words, your number one initial one right there with the first green arrow, that's
yeah.
where it has some force, right? So that's your buying. And then the rest where you have a lot of spinning tops and dirgies, what is the rule? To
hold, wait.
Hold. Exactly, and just wait.
Yeah.
Unless you're working on the confirmed lows or confirmed troughs, and then you can buy more, right? And then through that aspect, yeah, after all that energy in between, you could just have one or two positions and just wait. But that's good. I mean, you know, at least you have an intention, which is excellent. Okay, very nice, Ruba.
Thank you.
All right, next, Steve. All right, excellent.
I just set myself up with three different pairs to take advantage of what was going on with the British pound, and I moved myself to a different a window. And I lost all my elements.
That's okay.
Fibonacci's and everything else, and the trend lines went out the window. So anyway, it is what it is. I mean, I had three going at once, and I, you know, just kind of took half at one point. It takes some profit, and then I let the rest ride for a little bit, and then I closed out the positions.
Okay, and what was your intention for?
My intention was just to get in, you know, once the announcement was made, and then see how much I could get, you know, in a small amount of time, you know, just after the announcement for on the British pound.
Okay, excellent. So you've been busy with all the pound yens, pound dollar, and pound cat. Okay, great. But the beauty is that this talking about trading. The pound yen is totally different with the pound US dollar. Notice how the yen and the dollar and the CAD are three separate currencies. So that is definitely allowed. But if you have, say, pound dollar, then euro dollar, then dollar Swiss or Aussie US dollar, make it easier. And you all went long to all those three, then the dollar basically won, then you'll be in trouble. So in this particular scenario too, though, but since the base is the pound, if the pound was a negative news, then all those three trades will be in a negative as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I would recommend, you're in a practice mode, focus one and go through from there. But other than that, pretty good. All right, nice. Steve, then we'll go through with Raj.
So my intention was just to see which way the news is going to pan out.
Mm-hmm.
So I put all my demand in supply area and peak and trough line. So I started with this one because I thought they might be just playing up a bit, so I shorted.
Mm-hmm.
And then when it reached the demand area, I thought it, because it's hitting the demand area, it's up. The bulls should take control. It didn't really happen, so it wasn't going up then the price. It wasn't trying to reach high, so I got out of here. I thought maybe it's going to go other way around. But then I just waited for another two candles, and I thought, okay, now wasn't sure which way it's going to go, so I went short again. But then it started picking up from here, and I got out of, I thought, okay, I was right in the first place, so I went long again.
Nice.
And got out of here. And just to confirm that I was right, I just waited for a few minutes, few seconds, because it's a minute chart,
mm-hmm.
and then went up again and just basically wait up up here, got out, and then I thought maybe they're going to trace back the price now because the news is out,
mm-hmm.
but it didn't happen. So got out again, and here the news page is finished, and I finished it.
Okay, so what do you think is the learning experience from that trade?
I did very well today. I'm not happy puffy today. I'm not stressed. I'm not blowing a blush. It's normal.
Yes.
I'm under control. I like
very
fine.
Nice. So in other words, you're in the zone, right? Okay.
Yes.
Right. So just to correct one technique is that when there's a lot of force,
yeah.
never go against that force. Go with the force. So in other words, you know, you see that nice long candle right there where the when the report occurred, you can't go against it. Yeah. So despite you have a stability, what they tend to do, they have just to stabilize the price. Yes, there's a potential correction, but in most cases when it's too powerful, too strong, they have to keep on going until it gets exhausted at one point. So yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Other than that, well done. Congratulations. Okay. All right, then we'll go through Vicky.
Okay, so initially I entered short because there was still a lower high, although it was in an area of demand. So, but anyways, when the news came out, I reversed
uh-huh.
went in long, yeah.
Okay, and so what was the intention of the trade?
Just to momentum trade on the news.
Okay, and now what is the learning then for this, based on this trade?
To buy at demand.
Okay, very nice. There you go, very simple. Oh, good, very nice. Okay, next is Jenny. Just waiting for Jenny.
Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yes. Okay, all right.
So I did lots of fails. I got in, I was so impatient. I got in way too early.
Mm-hmm.
These were all buys.
Yes.
Because I thought it was going up, and I was, my intention was to try and work out transitioning.
Yes.
Which I just don't think I, but I know I didn't do very well, but I was kind of in anyway, I didn't understand transitioning, so I got all despondent and then went away from the computer
okay.
and came back here
mm-hmm.
and then got into the trade and then went up.
All right.
Yeah.
Nice.
I got into, I was too impatient, and I also, and it was going against me, so I got out.
Mm-hmm.
Rather moving it and then try to understand. And my intention, I say, was to understand transition, which
okay.
I did.
Which is good. So at least you gave it a shot in terms of to understand transition of trends, and therefore you will definitely do more type of exercises in terms of transition of trends. and the learning curve was the impatient spot. So it is good, all right? If you just write down on your trading log, that will be great. And at least, you know, you reacted based on the news. Bam, basically you answered. That's all basically that matters. And hence, I know you sent me your homework earlier. Highly recommend. These are the type of things you want to practice. These are the type of things you want to practice. And then, yeah, at least you can see the result from there as well, in terms of the time frame. All right, very nice. Good job, Jenny. And then next we'll go through James.
Good morning, Emma. Hello. Oh, 3 a.m. Wow, it's already 2 o'clock. I don't think it's possible right now.
Whenever you're ready, James. Okay. Sorry, James, I'm not there. Okay, let's go to the next one. Nate.
Okay, so basically, what I did was I switched it over to a 5-minute time frame, and I saw some Morningstar, and once it closed, I pretty much just bought it, and I just held it until the news hit. And my intention for the trade was to pretty much just make some money, and I had to take profit around this level right here, and I was going to hold it. However, I just decided to take my profit because it was kind of hesitating, so I just decided just to take it.
All right, no worries. At least you were aware of motion hesitation, and you won trade, so pretty good. Yeah, should be happy with that result, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. So the other strategy that you can now practice in future reference is to just leave some, right? Close some, leave some, then practice trailing. Okay. Great. Very good. Next, we'll have Julian.
So, I explained, lots of explanation today. So, yeah, first, so my intention was to use MTFA, okay, actually, so that was here, and this price was testing this low here.
Yes.
And we were still on a good good position to go long. So the first thing I did, where I bought here, not because of here, but because here. So here it was. You have a low here, and it was correcting. I put my fibs. It went around here, so it came up a little bit. So I bought here. And it started tanking again, and that's where I lost it, because actually I have a trade on the pound US.
Yes.
on the daily.
Mm-hmm.
I'm long, so I went to my real account. Yes.
Okay.
I lost it because it created a low.
Yes.
To this one, the long term one.
Mm-hmm.
So I lost it, and I went to even close the other trend.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I lost my concentration totally.
Okay, no
problem.
So you lost focus and concentration. What affected for the distraction in order for you to lose focus and concentration?
Sorry, what?
What caused the loss of focusness and distraction?
This time it's because I knew in the back of my mind I had the same trade and my real account.
Okay.
Yeah. And I wanted to cut short in case it tank more.
Yep.
Yeah. I still had my stop.
Okay. So in other words, you micromanage your account.
Yeah, I was this time.
Okay.
Because,
gotcha.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Penalty box. Right, but other than that, yeah, at least you're aware of the mistakes that you've done. But within that moment, though, that's where it's tough, because when you're in the situation and you're not thinking outside the box, we're going through a third eye view perspective, and you're letting your emotions control you, right? And hence, that's why you lost. That's why you know when you said you lost it, and that's what basically happens.
Yeah, I actually had the. I was bearish. As soon as I saw new low,
yep.
Lowest low,
mm-hmm.
I was even bearish here. But that was wrong.
Mm-hmm. What were your...
I was more focused on this low than the demand area.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Longer term, what was your viewpoint?
Uptrend.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Awesome. Stick to your guns.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so at least you know what to write in your trading log. And basically simple. All right, very nice. Okay, next. Let's go through Jeff.
Hello. I was actually going... with the trends I went with, saw the 15 minute and then I saw that it was still bearish. I was still losing steam, but with news it probably would have brought volatility. Then so I went to 1 minute chart. I thought these was just, it wasn't a level of demand, and I do agree. But also it was going on a downtrend on this one. So I kind of just decided to go with the trend and continuation, but it didn't do that. That was my analysis when I was doing this trade. I saw a stability, and then I thought it was going to move with the trend, but it didn't.
Okay, so where the error is, right? The actual error is you at least you acknowledge that selling level demand where you have a confirmation of a still a higher low. And you have a higher high and a higher low with the doji compared to the previous candle. No go. Okay, so let me know something to work on something with that one. Does that make sense there, Jeff?
Yes.
Okay. All right. No.
Hey, Ray.
Mm-hmm.
Would you say with the doji? You said something when you said doji and then no go.
Because Jeff sold it within that doji where it created a higher high and a higher low compared to the previous candle. And it created a confirmed higher low with that. Okay, so Jeff, can you circle the confirmed low where your entry point was, the doji of the entry point, your red arrow? Yes. The one next to it. So if you circle the actual trough itself, so that doji, the candle prior to that, you notice the candle prior to that, that's your trough, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you magnify it, you'll definitely see that that's an actual low itself. And notice how the price didn't want to go beyond their demand. hence there is now a big push in terms of the report. Sometimes either the marketplace itself will create some form of fear prior to a report. If they know that they want to push it up, then they need to create some form of a demand on the bottom. So what they tend to do is, when no one's selling, they will push the price to the downside just to create some form of fear. And then retailers will come in and say, oh, okay, you know, he's pushing to the downside, let's sell. But when price approaches a level of demand and the overview, and so in a bigger time frame of things, your overview is that you're bullish, you have to go with that. And you can't fight it. You will lose. So error number one, selling at a level of demand. You have to wait for a confirmation to break that demand in order for you to sell. That's a much less riskier in terms of trading, right? Okay, so that's good. All right, last but not least, let's go through Jason.
So I got in class right on time. And basically my intention of making these trades was trying to read the candles.
Mm-hmm.
And I entered late here, but then I entered here again because I know this, the force of this candle is really strong.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, closed it here, and then I just waited, entered here, and closed it. Yeah, and then I entered here, closed here, and I went short here for a short term, closed it here, waited, and then I entered here, closed there.
Very good. Excellent. A lot of improvement on your end. Okay, good. Can't complain on that one.
Nope.
Alrighty. And okay, one more. James. Let's see if James is back. And let me unmute you. Hello, James. Are you there? None. Okay. So, well done, everyone. Do you have any feedback to any person in the group? Any questions, queries, or challenges?
Nope.
None.
Nope.
Other than that, you know, like what? This is not the third week, in fourth week of performance base. It's awesome in terms of, if you're looking in terms of the graph, it's like that. Terms of performance. And then we're almost at the end of 2014. Pretty cool. Everybody's finishing strong, which is actually really good to see. Very good. All right, guys. Actually, you see something that makes me happy, actually. It's like, yeah. Like I said, if you're in the trading comp, you'll guys will kill everybody out there. Pretty good. Well, other than that, well done, and you guys have a good night, good evening, good morning, depending where you're at, and we'll see you tomorrow, FOMC, so 10:30, okay? 10:30, we have the FOMC, see if we can make more money tomorrow again, okay? So please make sure when you're coming in, make sure to come in nice and focused, frame yourself, and you're basically ready for battle, okay? You have to put your wire mentality, like what you just basically did today, and simply, you're just ready to rock. Okie dokes. I will see you guys tomorrow.
All right.